हेलो स्टूडेंट्स, माय नेम इज़ तहसीन शेख। वेलकम टू नागेश करजगी ऑर्किड स्कूल चैनल। दिस इज़ आवर सेकंड लेक्चर ऑफ ज्योग्राफी लेसन नंबर 2, लैंड, सॉइल, वाटर, नेचुरल वेजिटेशन एंड वाइल्ड लाइफ रिसोर्सेज। स्टूडेंट्स, इन द फर्स्ट लेक्चर वी हैव डिस्कस्ड अबाउट द स्टोरी ऑफ मांबा एंड पीटर। दिस मांबा एंड पीटर टू चिल्ड्रेन, दे आर लिविंग इन द डिफरेंट प्लेसेस। Now the physiographical condition, soil, availability of water, different vegetations, they are affecting their lifeline. Mamba, he is living in the Africa area, and Africa there due to these all natural resources are there, but due to less technology, Mamba's family is very poor. And in the Peter's house, Peter, he is living in the New Zealand area, and they having their own sheep wool factory with the agricultural land, and because of that they are enjoying the rich family status. So students, after that we have discussed land and the distribution of land on our earth surface. Near about 29% area is under the continents, 7 major continents like North America, South America, Australia, Africa, Asia, Europe and Antarctica. These 7 continents are covered 29% part, and remaining 71% area is totally under the water area. So students, this 29% area is not distributed equally. Some part it is under the mountain, some part under the river area, and some part using for the human settlement. So through this human settlements part, land is very important, because our all activities like construction, sometime playing, sometime roadways, railways construction, our school, industrial sector with agricultural production, we are only practicing on the land, and because of that land is very important. And nowadays day by day that land area under the forest we are cutting, and due to deforestation, high urbanization and the industrial sector and agricultural area we are expanding, and because of that forest area is start to deforestation is responsible for the less number of forest or decrease the number of forest on the globe. So students, after that in the first lecture we have discussed about the two type of land, community land and private land. Private land means what? Your own land, your own farm, your own flat, your bungalow, it is called private land. And community land means what? When we are going outside in the park, in the temple, zoo, these all things are under community. Not only one person who is enjoying, so many people, many community people, they are enjoying this place, it is called community land. And the today, in the today's lecture we are going to study about the land conservation. Okay student, so let's see, open page number in the textbook. See here, already we have learned the land. See page number 8 we have completed, and we are also seeing this image. See the difference of these images. Here pure village, and this village is converting into big city, and this is called the land transformation or the change of land use pattern. Now see the conservation of land resources we are studying on the page number 9 in the textbook. Okay, so students, why land resources conservation is important? Because the growing population and the growing demand of land, we want to preserve our land and we want to conserve our land is very important. So see, conservation of land resources, growing population and their ever growing demand has led to the large scale destruction of forest cover and arable land, and has created a fear of losing the natural resources. Therefore, the present rate of degradation of land must be checked. Afforestation, land reclamations, regulated use of chemical pesticide and fertilizer, and checks on the overgrazing are some of the common method used to conserve land resources. See students, many people, they are using chemical, pesticide, fertilizer in the farm, and because of that, that land area is start to degrade. And some other time our construction activity, our mining activities are responsible for land degradation. So what we have to do? We should do the land conservation and afforestation means when we grow more plant, with that some common mode of agriculture or industrialization, reduce the industrialization pollution. These all we can conserve the, through these all methods we can conserve our nature or our land. So students, main activities are there. It is called the weathering activity. Now weathering means what? See students, sometime the upper rocks, they are totally eroded due to some agents like river water or air. This air or river, they continuously breaking the rock, and this rock is converted into pieces, and this pieces is called soil. So next point we are going to study about the soil. We all know the soil. When we go outside of our school, garden is there, playground is there, and varieties of soil is found in the playground and garden. When we see the garden, black soil is there, and when we go to the playground, red soil is there. So why these colors are different? Place common place under your school campus, but two areas or the color of soil is different. So why? Because the soil color, the texture of soil or the minerals which are available in the soil is depend on the parent rock. Parent rock means what? If suppose three rocks are there, we all already we have learned the type of rock in the 7th standard: igneous rock, sedimentary rock and metamorphic rock. At the time of volcanic eruption, all material comes outside. After cooling and solidification, it's converting into igneous rock. Second one, these igneous rocks weathered by different agents like river water, sea waves, winds, underground water. These all agents, they eroded this material, and this due to this erosion, all material is transported or deposited on the another place. It is called deposition. And third one, after heat and process of this deposition, this deposited rock is converting into metamorphic rock. So students, this soil formation is depend on the parent rock. Parent rock ka color red hoga, soil it gets red color. Parent rock black होगा, soil जो होगी वो black color होगी. So due to that, these soils colors are different. The texture of soil is also different. So students, what is the meaning of soil? The upper layer of the earth surface is covered by some loose material. The thin layer of grainy subsistence, it is called soil. Okay. So see in the textbook on page number 9. What is the meaning of soil? Underline first one. The thin layer of grainy substance covering the surface of the earth is called soil. Okay. What is the meaning of soil? The upper layer of the earth surface is covered by grainy substance and it is called soil. It is closely linked to the land. Landforms determine the types of soil. Soil is made by organic matter, mineral, weathered rock and found on the earth. See students, some organic material, sometime when soil, rock is broken into a pieces, some type of organic material mixed in the soil, it is called organical material or organic matter. Second one, minerals. Yes, many minerals are found, sometime iron, sometime lignite, bauxite, manganese. These all varieties of things are occurred in the rock, and it is at as it is converting into soil. Next one, weathered rocks. Weathered rocks means just we have discussed the upper layer of rock is totally broken due to some material, due to some action of plants are also responsible for that. The roots of plants, it goes outside, goes inside in the earth, and due to that, that rock start to break. So these all activities are responsible for, it is called weathering, and due to weathering, soil is soil formation. And the right mix of mineral and organical matter make the soil fertile. If soil is fertile, we can easily grow agricultural crop in the soil. So students, see on the next page, page number 10. Landslide is there. Landslide means what? See in the image, one image is there, and in the hilly area or mostly in the foothill of the mountains, that upper layer of soil, it comes downside. Sometimes soil or sometimes rocks material students, this landslide is very common in the monsoon season. See, on the mountain, top of the mountain, this all material, it gets wet, and this wet material with water is coming downside, it is called landslide. In the our Maharashtra, Sindhudurga area or Mahabaleshwar, Lonavala, Khandala, Mumbai area, in the Pune also, its landslide is very common. The landslide area, that totally mountains are there, and this mountain rocks or mountain soil or some mud, these all materials is comes downside through the water or due to rainfall, it's come downside and is totally spread on the human settlement or sometime on the road tracks or the transportation mode disturbed due to landslide. And this landslide, it very dangerous because loss of life and property occur due to this landslide. See, the landslides are simply defined as the mass movement of rock. This mass movement of rock from upper portion to down slope. Okay, they often take place in a conjunction with earthquake, and sometime earthquake is also responsible for that. Earthquake means shaking of ground, and this shaking of ground, due to that, this all material comes downside. Flood and volcanoes, sometime floods with volcanic eruption is also responsible for landslide. A prolonged spell of rainfall can cause heavy landslide that can block the flow of river, and the quite some time the formation of river blocks and can cause havoc to the settlement downstreams on its bursting. See students, because of this landslide, sometime these all debris material stored in the river bank area and river not go outside, that overused of that water is responsible for the burst of the river channel on that particular place. In the hilly terrain, landslide have been a major and widely spread natural disaster that often strike life and property and occupy a position of major concern in the hilly area, mostly in the Jammu Kashmir or Uttarakhand, Assam, Arunachal Pradesh area. Due to heavy rainfall and the hilly area, this landslide is very common, and not only property, with the many human life is also under the threat due to this landslide. Okay students, see, one case study is there in your textbook. A massive landslide hit Pangi village near Rekong Peo in Kinnor district of Himachal Pradesh and damaged a 200 meter stretch of old Hindustan Tibet road, National Highway 22. See students, National Highway 22, it is located in the Himachal Pradesh area, and due to landslide, the triggered by intense blasting of Pangi village, and due to the blasting, this weak zone of slope collapsed and caused intense damage to the road and nearby villages. The Pangi village was completely vacated to avoid any possible loss of life. So this Pangi village is totally under this landslide area, and many people, they dead because of this landslide. See, mitigation. Now what we have to do, how we should take care, or how we should minimize the these all activities or minimize the threat due this landslide. See, we can hazard mapping in the locate area prone to the landslide. Many people, they are living in the mountainous area. When we construct these houses away from the land mountains area, at that time we can stop this type of landslide. Many time we can construct the walls also, that construction walls are very they stop the landslide area on that particular area. And many time trees or plantation, this plantation of trees also reduce the landslide or the capacity of landslide, increase the vegetation cover, the surface drainage control works to the control the movement of landslide. And these all type of if we reduce the construction activities on that particular area, and if we want to construct, we want to construct thoda sa dur construct karna chahiye humko us mountain se, tab ja ke hum ye sari cheeze kam kar sakte hai. So see, in the next page again, on page number, open the page number 11. Now next point we are going to study, the factor of soil formation, how to form the soil. See students, soil formation is here. See here, the top soil with humus and vegetation, this one is the top soil. Second one, rock material which weathered, and here parents rock. This parents rock is converting into soil, and this soil is useful for the natural vegetation or human life. It takes 100 of year to make just 1 centimeter of soil. Yes students, rainfall, temperature, sometimes some other agents, they broken these rocks, and it takes near about 100 to 500 year to converting this rock into soil. See here, factors of soil formation. The major factor of soil formation is the nature of parent rock and climate. Students, when parent rock is available, this parent rock, if it is strong, so it take more time to break, but when parent's rock is very smooth, it takes very less time to the break. So that's why the nature of parent rock is very important. Next important thing, climatic condition. Continuously climatic condition is changing day by day. If a hot temperature is there, suddenly is converting into rainfall, and due to hot temperature and rainfall at a time, that rock start to break easily. If suppose rock is here, and in that particular rock sometime water is accumulated, or the rain water is start to store. This storage water, due to less climatic condition, is start to freeze. Or this frozen material, again at the time of morning, due to high temperature, start to melt. Or this melting, this frozen melting, because of that, the pressure on the rock is increased, and because of that, rock is start to break. And sometime some our human activities, mining activity, construction activity, these all activities are responsible for weathering rock, and these rocks are converting into many pieces. So the climatic condition and parents rock, and the other factors of the topography. Next one, role of organic material. Organic material means what? Many animals, they are living in the soil, they are living in the rocks, like rabbit, mouse, snake, scorpions, earthworms, they all are living in the ground, and they are also responsible for weathering the rock. Sometime the taken for the composition of soil formation, and all this different from place to place. So this all the capacity of the soil formation is different from all place. So see students, soil is there in the textbook, climate, temperature, rainfall, and the weathering humus production is responsible for soil formation. It's time, it takes, sometime it takes more time, and sometime it takes less time. So that particular time is depend on the rock. Rock smooth hoga to easily break hoga, it take less time, but rock agar hard hoga to it takes more time, aur wo jaldi se break nahi hoga. Flora, fauna, and microorganism. Many microorganism, bacteria, they are living in the soil, and this flora, fauna, and microorganism is responsible for rock weathering. Relief. If slope is there, rock weathered easily. If slope is not there, it takes more time. So the relief, altitude, slope, and the accumulation of soil is responsible for that. And last factor, that is parent rock. Parent rock means, just we have discussed the main rock and the nature of main rock, it is broken into a pieces. If main rock is iron rock, or sometime the iron content is more, so soil is also converting into more with the more iron content. So main rock is mixed with the humus, or sometime with the some other content, so this soil also get the same content or same property. So this parent's rock is also important. So students, what we have discussed, we have discussed the formation of soil. On the next page, on the page number 12, we are going to study the how to conserve soil, or the soil conservation measures of the degradation. See students, soil erosion means what? First one we want to know. Soil erosion means the upper layer of soil is washed out and washed away. It is called soil erosion. Sometime soil is not washed away, soil reduces fertility. In the agriculture area, many farmers, they are using chemical, fertilizer, pesticide, and due to that they are taking overburden, or they are taking more crop in the farm, and because of that, that soil is start to erode, or soil reduces fertility. This is called soil erosion. Now who is responsible for that? Our deforestation, our human activity, sometime we all are responsible for that. See here, soil erosion and depletion are the major threats to soil as a resource. Both human and natural factor can lead to the degradation of soil. See students, not only human, natural regions are also responsible for the soil degradation. Factors which lead to the soil degradation are deforestation. Many time people, they are cutting the trees, and this cutting trees, trees roots, they covered the soil, they hold the soil moisture, but when we cut the trees, this soil is start to wash away, and because of that deforestation, overgrazing of animals, they eat the grasses, and these grasses expose the rock on that particular area. So overgrazing, overuse of chemical fertilizer in the farm, rain wash and landslide and flood, these all activities are responsible for soil erosion. And now, how to conserve soil? Let's see the soil conservation part in the next topic. First one, mulching. Mulching means what? The bare ground between plant is covered with a layer of organical matter like straw. It help to the retain soil moisture. See students, here that terrace farming, shelter beds, contour plugging, with that mulching. Mulching means what? We can use the organical matter like straw, and we can help to the soil erosion, or the soil moisture we can retain in the soil. Contour barriers. Contour barrier means what? Stone, grass, soil are used to build the barrier along contour, and trenches are made in front of the barrier to collect water. See, in the hilly area, water it comes downside, and with water soil is also coming down. So we want to stop here, that's why we are constructing some wall. Sometime we are using build some barriers to the contour line, and this soil is not comes downside easily due to this barrier. It is called contour barrier. Second one, rock dam. Rocks are piled up to slow down the flow of water, and this prevent gullies and further soil erosion. See students, in the map, in the on your textbook, all pictures are there, and when we construct the dam, rock dam, soil is not comes downside easily. Terrace farming. Terrace farming means it is also called just like stepped agriculture. In the hilly area, farmers, they growing crop on the hilly area, and the soil with water it comes downside easily. But when we construct a step like agriculture, water here, that water is come downside, so step is there. On the step, that water and the soil is accumulated, it's come downside third area, again they're accumulated. So one by one, according to the steps, that soil is accumulated, soil directly not coming downside. It is called terrace farming. Next one, intercropping. Different crops are grown in the alternate rows and are sown at different time to protect the solid from rain wash. See students, in the one if suppose this year I am going to grow one crop here, in the next year in the second row I can grow some another crop. Means interlocking means same time we are not using whole area, we are divided that area into rows. And first row में अगर मैंने ये साल crop cultivate किया है, तो next साल मैं क्या करूँगी? दूसरी row में करूँगी. Third time मैं क्या करूँगी? तीसरी row में करूँगी. So this type of intercropping is help to the reduce the soil erosion. Contour plugging. Contour plugging means again the agriculture which is parallel to the contour hill range and natural barrier for the water. And shelter belt. If suppose winds are here, now heavy winds are coming from all direction, my farm is here, that surrounding of farm I am growing some trees, and these tallest trees, they protect the winds, they protect the farm, means winds directly not enter in my farm because of the particular shelter bed. So in the coastal and dry region, rows of trees are planted to check the wind movement to protect soil cover. So this soil also covered, winds directly not enter in my farm because of this shelter bed. So these all things we can use for the soil conservation, and these all are called the soil conservation measure in India, and it could reduce the soil degradation. Okay students, now in the next part we are going to study about the water. Now why water is important? You people tell me the importance of water. वाटर इम्पोर्टेंस, यस वी रिक्वायर्ड वाटर फॉर ड्रिंकिंग पर्पज, विद दैट ओके फॉर क्लीनिंग, यस फॉर वॉशिंग क्लोथ्स, वेरी गुड. और क्यों लगता है वाटर, कौन बताएगा? फॉर एनिमल्स, वेरी गुड. यस एग्रीकल्चरल एक्टिविटीज एंड इंडस्ट्रियल एक्टिविटीज, मीन्स स्टूडेंट्स विदाउट वाटर वी कैनॉट सर्वाइव. वाटर इज वेरी इंपॉर्टेंट पार्ट ऑफ अवर लाइफ एंड बिकॉज ऑफ दैट वाटर वी आर गोइंग टू स्टडी इन दिस लेसन. नाउ ऑन अवर अर्थ सर्फेस इन द प्रीवियस लेक्चर और इन दिस लेक्चर ऑल्सो वी हैव डिस्कस्ड अबाउट द वॉटर. 71% एरिया अंडर द वॉटर, बट फ्रेश वॉटर सोर्स इज वेरी लिमिटेड. रिवर्स, ग्लेशियर्स, सम पॉन्ड्स, सम सीज, सम पॉन्ड्स एंड सम कैनल्स, दे आर अंडर द फ्रेश वॉटर. सो व्हाई वी कंजर्व द वॉटर, बिकॉज द सोर्सेस ऑफ वॉटर नाउ अ डेज इज स्टार्ट टू पॉल्यूट अवर एक्टिविटीज लाइक एग्रीकल्चर एक्टिविटी, इंडस्ट्रियल एक्टिविटीज, दे आर रिस्पॉन्सिबल फॉर वॉटर पॉल्यूशन. सो बिकॉज ऑफ दैट वॉटर इज अ नेचुरल रिसोर्सेस एंड इट इज वेरी इंपॉर्टेंट रिसोर्सेस नॉट ओनली फॉर ह्यूमन बींग्स, प्लांट्स, एनिमल्स, एग्रीकल्चर, इंडस्ट्री, वॉटर ट्रांसपोर्टेशन, हाइडल पावर जनरेशन. फॉर दिस ऑल पर्पज वी रिक्वायर्ड एबंडेंट ऑफ वॉटर एंड बिकॉज ऑफ दैट वी आर गोइंग टू स्टडी अबाउट द वॉटर. सी वॉटर इज अ वाइटल रिन्यूएबल नेचुरल रिसोर्सेस. 3/4 ऑफ द अर्थ सर्फेस इज कवर्ड विथ वॉटर. इट इज देयर फॉर अप्रोप्रिएटली कॉल्ड द वॉटर प्लैनेट. अवर प्लैनेट इज टोटली ब्लू बिकॉज 71% एरिया अंडर द वॉटर एंड दिस वॉटर इज कवर्ड बाय मेजर 4 ओशियन, पैसिफिक ओशियन, अटलांटिक ओशियन, आर्कटिक ओशियन एंड इंडियन ओशियन. सो दिस ऑल ओशियंस दे आर कवर्ड मेजोरिटी पार्ट एंड ड्यू टू दैट आवर अर्थ सर्फेस इज कॉल्ड वॉटर प्लैनेट. सी इट वॉज इन द प्रिमिटिव ओशियन दैट लाइफ बिगेन ऑलमोस्ट 3.5 billion years back. Even today, the ocean cover 2/3 of the earth's surface and support a rich variety of plants and animal life. In the oceanic area also, varieties of fishes or some aquatic animals and the different type of plants found in the water area. See, the ocean water is however saline. Ocean water we cannot use because salinity more. We can use only the fresh water because in the fresh water salinity amount of saline is very less. So ocean water or the sea water is not good for drinking purpose. So the ocean water is however saline and not fit for human consumption, and fresh water account for only 2.7%. See students, underline the word, only 2.7% water under the fresh water. Nearly 70% of these occur as a ice sheet and glacier in the Antarctica, Greenland, mountain region, and due to their location they are inaccessible. So students, the water point is very big and very important topic. We will discuss this water topic in our next lecture because already 30 minutes are over and we have completed land conservation, soil and how to conserve soil. In the next lecture we will discuss water, and as a homework you should write about the soil conservation, okay, how to conserve the soil. We will meet in the next period. Thank you students.